Hello, I'm Mr. Anitya, a retired lecturer in metallurgy, preaching Christianity and Sikhism. Sikhism is continuation of Christianity, and Nanak was the second coming of Jesus. And people who are twice born, only they will know it through Holy Spirit, the living God, which is our supernatural Father Elohim, Allah Parbrahm, is only known to the living in spirit people and not dead in spirit. Spirit is different from soul. Soul is make you living, natural person. Flesh and soul make a natural person. And Holy Spirit, which is common sense, is by the grace of our Father, which you can use it or misuse it. So this is the Holy Spirit. So there you are. A person is born among in the tribal home. We can learn the letters from the rabbi, dead letters. But this thing will be known only due to the people of Holy Spirit. So the dead letters, like Peter and in the university professors, they just are dead letters. And they vomit it out and they teach the same thing to their next generation, without any understanding. So when you get the Holy Spirit, then you detect the corruptions in the books. Because what is written is corruptible. But when you become twice born, then you get gospel through revelations. That means through logical reasoning. So when you are capable of logical reasoning, then you get gospel, then you can, this is wrong. This is right or wrong. Like Genesis 17, chapter on circumcision, where it is written, you know, you can make a Jew outwardly, any person who is not born of the seed of Isaac, you can circumcise him and make him a Jew, black, brown or white. Whereas the circumcision is the tribal mark of Abraham to Isaac and his seed only. So anybody born of the seed of Isaac is to be circumcised, nobody else. If somebody else gets circumcised, he becomes super bastard fanatic devil. As you can see them today, people in India, Pakistan, they are circumcised. They have nothing to do with Semitic race. So they are super bastard fanatic devils, and they will kill them, because Joseph told them when he went to the temple that Abraham was a noble man. Don't make fake sons of Abraham. But they were making money out of them. So Mammon, for the sake of Mammon, they circumcised people and they altered the text. That is called, Jesus called them, the old cloth dwelt holes, and it become useless. So these scripts are not allowed into the church. That's why Jesus said, when you go on preaching, don't take money in your pocket, no two shoes, no tunic, and no script. Script means Bible in your hand. That means these Bible thumpers that you see them in churches and other things, they are anti-Christ. They don't understand, they don't know what they are talking about. What is written, they are vomiting it out. What is written is corrupted, old cloth full of holes. The Messianic Jews, when they enter the fold of Christ Jesus, which was Mammon free, people sold their property to form the community. When they enter this church, they bring in Torah and again the greed, Mammon, and they build big churches to attract more Mammon, and they establish the same thing as in the temple used to be. They replace the temple high priest with the bishop and all these stooges. So this Pope is replacement of the temple high priest. So he has nothing to do with God, he is Antichrist. He can't give your account to God. And the rabbi used to give the account of the people at Passover. But these docker priests can't give your account at all. Wherever they get good money, good salary, they leave the church and go there. So they are working for Mammon. These churches have become Mammon worshippers. No God is worshipped there. If a person like me goes there, they will turn them out. I go to a Catholic, I live in Reading near university, and they have a Williams, you know, there's a Catholic Orthodox church next to my house. I go there sometime with these t-shirt and other thing, and one of their docker priests, you know, the father they call him, you can't come into the church with this shirt on. It's objective. I don't like it. So I said, then if you don't like it, it's not my fault, but I know my two fathers. One is my tribal father, natural, this one. We are from a god, the son named Niger. And I know supernatural father, God. Can you tell me what type of father you are, you know, with this dog collar and all that robe? He had no answer. He said, you don't question a father. So that's how he was rude, you know, and then it showed me out, you know. So never mind. So here I'm doing a gospel, holy gospel of our supernatural Father, Elohim, Allah, Parbrahm, etc., delivered by the first anointed Christ, which we call Satguru, Jesus, according to St. Luke 20, verse 27 to 40. Some Sadducees, those who deny that there is a resurrection. So the Pharisee then, you know, admitted that there is a resurrection, and Sadducees don't. Sadducees are like these Mohammedans who say, you know, Allah has no son, but they call Allah Abba, Father. If you call Allah Father, then automatically you become son, you know. You don't need to prove that Allah has no son. So you can see how blind they are, especially as their rabbis or their mullahs tell them, they do it. So some Sadducee, those who deny that there is a resurrection, came forward and put this question to Jesus, saying, Teacher, Moses wrote for us. That means they are men of letters. If someone's brother dies, leaving a wife but no child, his brother must take the wife and raise up descendants for his brother. Now, there were seven brothers. The first married a woman but died childless. Then the second and the third married her, and likewise all the seven married died childless. Finally, the woman also died. Now, they remember that childless means that she was left virgin. When you are going for God, you must be virgin. If you are married, you can't go to God, because that narrow gate that leads to the royal vineyard, to our Father, no two person can pass through, only single. So that's a good, you know, that child, she was left virgin, you know, that no children. Or also the royal priests, you know, they don't make following. Following are children, you know. So royal priests themselves are solitary, they make other people solitary. Then the second and the third married her, and likewise all seven died childless. Finally the woman also died. Now at the resurrection, now they did not believe in resurrection, you know, but they are talking about resurrection. Now at the resurrection, whose wife will that woman be? For all seven had been married to her. But she, you know, all married her, but she did not become Mrs. of any, because she remained virgin, childless. Jesus said to them, the children of this age marry. This age mean? That mean Pharisee and Sadducee age, when they were the rabbis, efficient. That mean moral teacher. The children of this age marry and remarry, in which incarnation takes place. Now this marriage and remarriage, you won't understand unless you understand Matthew 19, parable of marriage and divorce, in which Jesus stated, you know, the spiritual marriage, in which, you know, the man leaves his mother and father. Man is soul. Soul inside you is the master of this one. Without soul, this person is dead. So soul is the one which governs, you know, you do this thing, do that thing and all that. Soul is the master of our, this house. So for this reason, man leaves his mother and father, God, to join his wife, flesh, in the womb of the woman. And when they join together, they are no more two, but one person. Can you see that union with your two naked eyes? No. You perceive it with a third eye of logical reasoning. So the things of God are not seen, but perceived. People who are twice born, only they can perceive, not the once born people, dead in spirit. Only the men of letters can know what is written, scripts. Beyond that, they don't know. So, letters are for this physical marriage. So that's why Devaji is saying that you marry physically, man and wife, and when they die, and they come back again in reincarnation. In which reincarnation takes place, not incarnation. So they are reincarnated, you know, again. But when you know our supernatural father, when you are twice born, then you become the son of the Most High, then there is no more death and rebirth. Cycle is broken and you are eternal like your father. Reincarnation takes place. But those who are deemed worthy to attain to the coming age means the new covenant of Christ, in which you have to be solitary, not to go by what your rabbi tell you or this man tell you. Like that woman was virgin. So she was capable of entering into the new age of Christ, and to the resurrection of the dead. Neither marry nor are given in marriage, as shown in Lazarus. So they don't marry, given in marriage, as in reincarnation. But in Lazarus, you know, as shown, he became one with our father. He was sitting in the lap of Abraham, righteous person, and he was with God, as Abraham was with God. They can no longer die, for they are like angels, perfect in gospel. Like angels, you know, are perfect in the moral laws. People who are perfect in the moral law, they are called angels. Those who preach gospel, perfect in the gospel, they are called saint, or the sons of the Most High. Angels can't sit at the table. Angels are waiters, waiting to take the position at the table. Remember, when Judas Iscariot was thrown out, then Matthias was chosen. He was the angel waiting to sit at the table. So the people sitting at the table, 11 of them, they invited Matthew, come, sit with us at the table. So he became a saint. So angel is lower than the saint. Angel is the witness to the light, but not light. That's why John the Baptist has wing, and he is carrying a piece of paper with letters written on it. They teach moral law, angels. And saints, they preach gospel. So that's the difference between angel and saint. Saint, they are eternal. And angels are not eternal. They have to go into the life and death cycle, unless God willeth. So die for are like angels, perfect in gospel. They are the children of God, because they are the ones who will rise. The saint, they rise, you know. Like father, like sons, eternal. That the dead will rise, even Moses made known in the passage about the bush, when he called Lord the God of Abraham, the God of Isaac, and the God of Jacob, because they were righteous people. That's why they had the God of this one. Remember, Joseph had the God of Most High God, whereas the 11 crook brothers, because they were not righteous, they had Satan in their heart, saltless people. So God of Jacob, and he is not God of the dead in letters, but of the living and Holy Spirit, common sense. For to him all are alive. So you know that I've made a motto, Holy Spirit, common sense, Spirit with small s, you know, not capital S. Capital S is extraordinary sense. Holy Spirit shatters the fetters of the letters. So unless you are capable of shattering the fetters of the letters, you can't preach gospel. So gospel is for those who are predestined of our Father. So, but living in the Spirit, common sense, for to him all are alive. Some of the scribes said in reply, Teacher, you have answered well. And they no longer dare to ask him anything. So this is a nice, here it is, you know, the seventh husband. If you want to know, this is my book, which I have written, and it is the Venora, which give you the seventh husband. These six are works, you know, these David's cross works. Three evil works, three holy. That's why the two triangles are opposite. Social, economical, and political affairs. And they are works. Works lead to reincarnation. By grace of God, you become the Son of the Most High. This is God, Elohim, Allah, Parbrahm. And these are the works. They light this candle with this candle. So all have the light of our Father, Supernatural Father. And by grace, you know him. So this is, I have written that on the side, you know, there are these 12 had nothing to do with the 12 tribes of Israel or anything. The 12 were 7 in the name of John the Baptist and 5 in the name of Christ Jesus, making it 12. Nothing to do with the 12 tribes of Israel, because God has nothing to do with the secular property. He is concerned with our spiritual self, which can't be have anything. So this is the book I have written. Anybody interested to help me to revise it, I will much appreciate. So our Father God blesses you.